without further ado, please put your hands together and give a Billy Taylor Summerfest Jazzmobile welcome to Mr. Jay Hoggard.
Video. evening.
Good evening.
Peace and blessings to y'all.
Yeah, peace and blessings.
Here we are at the western corner of Harlem. And it looks like Harlem. There's a lot of subtlety in that statement. I'd like to introduce my colleagues on the keyboards. James Weidman. Y'all know James. James Weidman. Yeah, there you go. On the bass, Belden Bullock. On the drums, Mr. Pheeroan Aklaff. Pheeroan Aklaff. And on the alto and soprano saxophone, a very special guest. It's always an honor to play with this great gentleman of the music, one of my best friends and heroes, Gary Bartz. Gary Bartz. So the name of that composition was Arigen, written by Sonny Rollins. And how many of y'all know that what Arigen is spelled backwards?
Nigeria.
Nigeria. All right. The next composition is something that I wrote for y'all, and it's entitled Harlem Jazzbirds Swingin' and Swayin'.
John, if I get up.
See, I was kind of expecting that y'all were gonna say, yeah, okay, I wanna hear that. There you go. Harlem Jazzbirds Swingin' and Swayin'. One, two.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Belden Bullock on the bass. Pheeroan Aklaff on drums. Gary Bartz. My name is Jay Hoggard, and that composition is another one that is on Harlem Hieroglyphs. It's entitled I Am Free. What time am I, Robin? It's 8 o'clock. Good, we got enough time. We praise God for our blessings. You know, I need to say something about Jazzmobile. I'm a product of Jazzmobile. I started in 1971, and I put a little story on Facebook the other day. Some of y'all may have read it. If you're not my friends, please, click on that thing. But anyway, I was 17, and that was my first time driving down to Jazzmobile when it was at IS-201. And on 127th between Madison and Park. Yeah. And anyway, I was struggling to get the vibraphone. As you can tell, the vibraphone is a large instrument. When I was 17, I had a small instrument. Anyway, I'm going in, and I had been there one time before, but it never, didn't have the vibes. Anyway, I was having a problem getting up the steps, like these steps, except there were more, and I didn't have my son, who's now 30, to help me get up the steps, because I was 17 at the time. And that was a joke, too, but joke. Anyway, a gentleman helped me take the vibes upstairs, and then I got upstairs, and then I realized that I left the car in an illegal spot, so I ran downstairs and parked the car and came back, and the vibes weren't where I had left them, and kind of freaked out, but then I went in the room where I was supposed to have my class, and they were in there, and they were set up. And I said, well, who brought my vibes in here? And they said, Lee Morgan. So Lee Morgan is the guy that helped that 17-year-old kid carry the vibes up the steps. He was a friend of Gary Bartz. He was one of my heroes. I never got a chance to thank him for helping me. But that was my first entrance at Jazzmobile, studying with people of that caliber. And I stuck with it, and 50, more than a few years later. Jazzmobile. And so the great Dr. Billy Taylor, who was the founder and one of the great, great, greats, true inspiration. I had the opportunity to record with him. Oh, maybe we'll play that after. I didn't have that on this set. Anyway, the great Billy Taylor. And I want to give a round of applause to the wonderful current director of Jazzmobile, Ms. Robin Bell Stevens. I also did that so in case I go over a little bit, she won't be yet pulling out. the next composition. Oh, and one other story I want to say about playing here. The last time I played here on this stage was with Lionel Hampton. At that time, Hamp was about 89 or maybe 90, and he used to call me to sub for him sometimes, but he would always sit next to me because he still wanted to drive the ship. So the last time I played right up here, Hamp was sitting where I'm standing in a wheelchair, and I played Stomping at the Savoy and A-Train and his tunes, and Hamp sat right here the whole time. And then when we played Flying Home, he got up, and I was like, oh, Hamp, you don't have to. He got up slowly, grabbed the sticks out of my hands. Took about 3 minutes to get the first hand up, but it came down. Second one, took it up, came down. Then the next one, then the next one, then the next one, the next one, the next one, the next one. Hamp was back being 28. All right, last story. I know. Another reason that it's always very special to play here is because in the first years of Jazzmobile, my father's office, these trees that are here weren't always this tall. They were shorter back in the late 60s. And my father's office was in that building back there, in a church center, which is right next to Riverside Church. He was a secretary treasurer of the Department of Foreign Missions of the African Methodist Episcopal Zion Church. Room 1910. And so I used to look out from that window sometimes. I used to see these people out here, except it was down at that end, and there was this truck. I was like, what is that truck? And then they had great musicians out there, Billy Taylor and Duke Ellington and everyone who's everyone. And Milt Jackson, I saw later many, many, many times on that truck back there. So the truck is going to be a very valuable museum piece soon. So right now we're playing here on the cement. And the name of this piece, in reference to that building and to the great Riverside Church, Piety and Redemption.
Thank you. check on the mailing list?
Yes.
To your church office is never open.
They're not open on Friday, and it's up to 2 o'clock. But that's where you got to...
Thank you.
You're on.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
Pheeraan Aklaff on the draw. Mr. Belden Bullock on the bass. James Weidman on the organ and piano. Baltimore's finest, Mr. Gary Bartz. So the name of the composition, Piety and Redemption, and then the last one was A Walk Through the Colorful Forest. God bless y'all. All those songs are on my album. My record's back there if you'd like to purchase them. God bless you. See you soon. Long live Jazzmobile!
Johnny Gary would say, you don't have to go home, but you've got to leave here. Bye.